we met at a barbershop. I took my son to get his haircut, and you know, he looks very well on the eyes. So I asked the barber, you know, who is he? He told me, you know, oh, that's Matthew. He's good people. You know, go holler at him. So I went outside and we exchanged numbers.
I remember how we met. You know, I was in the barbershop. I was just now getting my hair cut. I was finishing up. And before, you know, I was, you know, giving my barber a handshake, telling him a good job for my haircut. I seen her walk in, and we just had this moment where we just locked eye to eye. It's a split moment. And then, you know, I thought to myself, you know, she's a very attractive girl, you know, and I didn't think too much of it. So I walked out. I was about to leave, and before I know it, I heard a knocking on my window. And I looked over to my left, and it was her. And we had a conversation. It was more along the lines of, you know, I think you're cute. Maybe we should, you know, chat sometime. You should take my number. I gave her my number, and then it was on from there.
Matthew was the one. We had went out on a date. We went on a date. And when we went on the date, he expressed some of his feelings towards me. He said something that had really caught my attention. And when he said that, I was like, yeah, he's the one for me. He's the one for me.
I figured out she was the one. She invited me to her place one time. And I just saw the way her hospitality was, it was really what got me, and her mannerisms, her personality. She was a very sweet girl. I remember the first night I came over, we watched the movie. And I just kind of, just after having conversations with her all night, I figured I really like this girl. I really want to be with this girl. And so from then on, I guess my heart just felt like she was the one for me. I know. I feel like this is going to last a long time.
I think I said I love you first. And when I first said I love you, he went on and he was like, he never did say I love you back. He went on, he was like, oh yeah, why do you feel like that? He tried to make it into a conversation instead of saying I love you back. So to answer the question, I said I love you first.
I remember one night we went out to eat, and we had a really good night. You know, it was just a really good night. We came back. I thought we were gonna, you know, get everything ready for bed, you know, take our showers and everything. I walk in and there's like rose petals on the ground. There's candles lit. Everything smells good. You know, the bed's all made, everything's clean, it's in this candles, and it's just real romantic setting. And so we just kicked it off from there, and she wore this,
No. We're not.
let's just say she wore this outfit that I really liked, and the vibes were all just romantic from then, and it made me feel more in love with her. It just made me feel more like this girl is for me. And she just really made me happy from there. And it just kept on from there.
Despite what they've heard, someone as mighty as a lion, but still as gentle as a bluebird. And someone you don't have to tell, you don't want to be lost. Having someone you can grow old with until God calls us home. with someone who understands that a thug has feelings too. Someone who loves you for sure. You never let them go. Cause all we know is when they fall gone, and they will be by your side still.
The most romantic thing he did to steal my heart. Honestly, I think women are a little different. So the most romantic thing he did to steal my heart and that he still does is when he get, you know, the kids or the little ones. Because, I mean, when the baby, when we had our baby, she was premature. And one of the things he did that stole my heart when she first came home, you know, most men don't get up at 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 o'clock in the morning with a baby. And even though he had to be up, you know, for work at the break of dawn, he would still get up at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Like, it didn't matter what time it was, he would still get up with her. And I think, you know, as a woman, that really stole my heart. That meant a lot to me. Matthew proposed at our baby shower. Yeah, it was a surprise, and he came and he proposed at our baby shower.
I felt wonderful. I felt amazing. I felt like God answered my prayers. I felt like that was the day that it was set in stone that she's going to be the woman of my life. Mm-hmm. More serious one, I feel like it would be her.
It's him. No.
I feel like it's him.
He's the most serious one.
Because I could say stuff. I'll really be joking around, but she'll kind of sometimes, you know, with her, you know, I know women sometimes can be sensitive, but sometimes some of the stuff that I can say, I don't realize that she can take it in another way. I don't ever mean to hurt her or hurt her feelings, but sometimes she can be real sensitive, and, you know. Sometimes I have to be real soft with her. I would say she's the more funny one. She's always making me laugh. She's always being goofy. And that's what I love about her, because she has a really good sense of humor. And me personally, I like a woman with a good sense of humor. And she has that. So that's a really good plus.
What? Say it ain't so. All right now. Attractive and loyal.
Loyal and amazing. For me, it would mean that it's set in stone that I get to spend the rest of my life with her. She gets to spend the rest of her life with me. And I wouldn't have it no other way at this point in time. I wouldn't have it no other way. But she's the one for me.
For me, it would mean everything. You know, growing up from a young girl, we always think, you know, we dream of that day that I marry my Prince Charming. And, you know, we have these big old dreams for ourselves. And we never think that they're going to be reality. So just to know that it's going to be so real, you know, I mean, literally, he is my Prince Charming. He is my everything. He is my Boaz. And just to have him and to have this marriage and to have this union, it would mean everything to me.
Pretty little thing, a couple of bags in her hand, right in front of Macy's. That's where all the pretty girls hang. Then I saw her at the food court, sipping lemonade, conversating on her cell phone, looking so amazing. And I said to myself,
gon' wear my ring.
She gon' take my name.
Take her to the cookout.
Me and Matthew, we are so excited to be newlyweds and to love on each other. Thank you guys so much for coming to our wedding and coming to our reception. We appreciate you guys so much.
Thank you. Thank you all for coming to see this wonderful ceremony. And we just appreciate